Hey, what's up, guys? RonMan coming back at you, and today we're taking a look at Super Adventure Island for the Super Nintendo. Also, if you're new here and you like my content, please make sure to hit the like and subscribe buttons, as well as that bell notification so you stay up to date with RonMan Gaming. Back in the day, the NES was home to the Adventure Island trilogy. The first Adventure Island was practically just a copy of Sega's Wonder Boy. After the release of Adventure Island, Nintendo and Hudson Soft began to experiment with new gameplay ideas to ensure the sequel would be a more engaging and exciting experience for players. With the addition of animal buddies, an inventory system, and a beautiful world map packed full of new locations, Adventure Island 2 did not disappoint. About a year after the release of Adventure Island 2, Super Adventure Island was released for the Super Nintendo. The graphics and the music were a huge improvement over the NES games, as expected. But what was unexpected is that, in terms of gameplay, Super Adventure Island feels more like a step back from what they had achieved in Adventure Island 2. Gone are the animal buddies, the inventory, and the world map. In this sense, Super Adventure Island appears to be more like a remake or retelling of the first game rather than a true 16-bit sequel. However, if you enjoyed the first Adventure Island, you'll probably enjoy Super Adventure Island as well. It's just more of the same, but with better music and visuals. Now, if you happen to be unfamiliar, Super Adventure Island is an action platformer where you take control of Master Higgins as you play through several island-themed levels on a quest to save your girlfriend. Super Adventure Island does a good job at mixing up the variety of the locations you visit. My favorite is the Misty Forest stage. The levels all have a decent length, and occasionally you'll face off against different bosses. There are two weapons you'll find on your journey, the tomahawk and the boomerang. You can power up the weapon you have by collecting more of the same weapon. Sometimes, though not often, you'll come across a skateboard power-up that allows you to move faster as well as take an extra hit before you die. Now, I'm not complaining, but I always thought this franchise seemed so random. Almost as if Hudson Soft just put a bunch of words into a hat, and by luck, drew out what this game would be.
Alright guys, I hate to bring you into the boardroom like this, but the boss has really been riding me about this next video game, so we gotta knock this one out the park, alright? So what I need you to do is write down your best, most creative ideas. We're going to put them in this hat. We're going to stir it up. And then we're going to read them. And I'm going to tell you what the next game is going to be. Are you ready? Don't you let Hudson Soft down, Higgins. You screwed us on that last one with your terrible ideas. Already? All right, give me a... All right, go ahead. Put it in the hat. Put it in the hat. Let's see what we got. All right. Thank you, sir. Thank you. All right, let's mix up the hat here. All right. The first... Okay, I can see you guys are thinking hard about this one. We got Island, okay? It's gonna take place on an island. You gotta throwing that out. Next one. All right. Okay. Oh, man. Don't burn your brain cells out. You got skateboard here. All right. You gotta think about something with a skateboard or whatever. Let's see what's happening next. Oh, Higgins, I can tell this was your idea. Tomahawk. Okay. So listen, we got an adventure somewhere on an island with a guy riding a skateboard, and maybe he has like a tomahawk for a weapon. All right, now go make this game and knock it out of the park for me.
See, I told y'all, I knew it. Although Adventure Island looks and sounds great, there are some negatives I would like to touch on. The biggest issue, in my opinion, is that this game is boring as fuck. I'll just say it. This game's fucking boring. The level layouts are really bland. Not quite something I'd expect from a game called Super Adventure Island. I guess I didn't really know what I expected. Certainly not skateboarding on sand while throwing tomahawks. But the levels drag on for longer than they should, and there really isn't much going on. Just go to the right and hope you don't get hit. Speaking of which, one hit and you're dead. Ugh, you know, I hate when games do that. At least with Contra, you jumped right back into where you were. But not in this game. When you die, you go back to the beginning of the stage. Ugh, this is really tedious, especially if you were at the end of a level. Boss levels are a real pain in the ass too. Bosses are not exactly hard, but there's a good chance you'll take a hit while you're trying to figure out what to do. And guess what? If you die on a boss stage, they make you go back to the beginning of the previous stage. What's up with that? The weapons can also be pretty annoying. For example, I much prefer the boomerang over the tomahawk, but there are times where this game really seems to want you to take the tomahawk. Like right here. I don't want that, but it looks like I don't have much of a choice, so I guess I'm taking it. Okay, so this is just a me thing, but I really don't like Master Higgins. I just think he looks like a doofus with his lips all puckered up while he runs on the spot and his stupid hat. I don't know. I'm just not a fan. He's not as bad as Chuck Rock.
Unga bunga.
But still. All in all, Super Adventure Island is not a bad game. It's a nice looking but simple platformer with really good music. The gameplay leaves a lot to be desired and ultimately is kind of boring. I'm not too sure why they didn't continue to build on top of what Adventure Island 2 had started. Instead, they went back to the basics, which I think is a huge missed opportunity. To answer a question the NES complex might ask, is it fun? No. But just because I don't find it fun doesn't mean that you won't. Super Adventure Island isn't a rare nor expensive game, and if you find it out in the wild, I would consider picking it up. You won't be blown away by any means, but maybe you'll find more enjoyment than I did. Guys, I want to thank you so much for watching, and thank you, Jay, the NES Addict, for helping me with this video. Please check out his channel if you haven't already. Please make sure to hit the like and subscribe buttons, as well as that bell notification, and we will see you guys next time.